What does this mean?
Ha. I think you've been blocked.
Nobody above blocking. Do you like Olori Buruku? I block you.
Hi guys, welcome back to Wacko's Review, the only Nigerian reviewer that bought his girlfriend a Birkin bag. Birkin. So if you guys want a Birkin bag, use your hand and smash that subscribe button. Turn on post notifications so you'll be notified whenever I post. And yeah, like this video also and Birkin bag. The final episode of the Men's Club Holiday Special came out and I instantly got angry at the end. How will you make a whole episode and you did not add Dunkanka Tongues? What? Am I joking to you? What? You know what? I'm going to talk about him. So, Dunkanka Tongues was with his new babe and he was just feeding her strawberries. And that's all he did. Also, I like that guy. Louis and Lola were the center of all attention for the first two episodes. And the sad part is they did not get that much screen time in this episode. Yes, they were there, but they were mostly supporting characters that I hated. Like, yeah, when Lola had to hear Misty talk, no one ever should be subjected to do that. And also, yeah, when Louis had to act like he knows this Kojo guy.
Guy, I'm sorry, I don't know you, but you are cheap.
This Lucram is douche. This dummy force. This Orami Glufis.
Speaking of packs, I was not even talking about packs, actually. I was trying to segue to this guy. In my last review, I made it clear that I would never like Kojo, no matter what. He might feed the hungry kids in Africa, he might stop global warming, and I'll still find a way to hate him. And this is only because I hate anyone richer than me. Yes, I hate everyone on it. But Kojo is a joker. So at the beach party, Kojo spoke on how Aminu stole a girl from him. And the girl Aminu stole from him was no one but my queen, my heart, my love, my life, my legs, my happiness, Jalo! He surprisingly saw her first and made a move on her, and he used a line here that after he opened his mouth, I'm not even lying, they should have had like 10 platoons of soldiers standing outside ready to arrest this guy. And see, listen guys, they don't even need to arrest him, he just needs to make one fatal move and the guns go wild. He tried to help her out with her car issues, but Aminu also dropped another line here that made me off my TV.
Someone as pretty as you should have someone as rich as me to buy you a brand new car, not call mechanics.
Okay, once in a while, I need to act professional, and over the years, I have attacked and bashed two characters, and to be honest, they did nothing to me but be themselves. And I feel that will stop now. Misty and Aminu, I am sorry. I will not attack you guys again. So this episode continued with Aminu giving Misty more packages. In the last episode, he bought her a Benz. In this episode, I can't stop myself from attacking them. Like, what the hell are they even doing? Like, what the hell? I hate them. I hate them. Why are they enjoying their life? But Aminu wanted her to come and meet him in their abroad. I know she has been the one handling Jasmine child. Oh, you did not know? You don't know Misty is a house girl? Oh, you do not know? I don't need to go into details, guys, but she's the one. But the funniest thing happened to Misty. So someone came into Aminu's house to take Patrick's child, and Misty initially was about to destroy this person because, like, how rude can you be to just enter someone's house and not even greet anybody at all? So Misty, as she was about to change it for this lady, the visitor then ended Misty immediately.
Do I look to you like a kidnapper?
When you walk in somewhere, introduce yourself.
You know, I don't have time to waste my energy paying respect to one of Aminu's concubines.
Taya was obviously the center of attention in this episode. His story continued after Hadiza schooled him in the last episode. But Hadiza wasted her time here because, if you did not know, only Breeze, they entered this guy's head.
That you needed someone to keep you company because Tiara is not around.
But he wasn't bothered about Hadiza at all because, you know, he only goes for kids that have money. Then at the beach party, he tells a story about how he met his rich wife. Do you remember her, guys? Eh? Now that slept with Tayo's brother, then made Tayo raise his brother's child. I know that trick. It's an old trick. Someone wanted to do it for me, but thank God I ran away before the DNA test came back. The surprising thing about his ex-wife was how similar her and Tiara's story seemed. It looked like they copied the same story. And if you think I'm lying, watch. His wife was a rich brat that hated the air in Lagos. Does that sound familiar? He works for her dad. Guys, I said, does that sound familiar? No one answered me. Should I go on? Because this is all I have. She first surprised him with a gift, and after he became aware of who actually bought the gift for him, instead acting like how shy guys act in pornos, it's always like this, oh, you shouldn't have. You're my boss's daughter. Don't ask me how I know that thing. Initially, Tayo seemed like he wouldn't fall for her antics, but it was hard. Because you see, Tayo is from the depths of Africa, and he's hungry. And as soon as I saw the food in front of him, I knew it was over.
I said if it's just this Lucrami's goose, this dummy force, this Orami goose.
After finishing his story, he then saw that Tiara blocked him. Was it Tiara that blocked him? Guys, was it Tiara that blocked him? I'm confused there. I don't know if it's Tiara that blocked him. Hi.
Hello.
Hello, I came to ask you something first. I'm going to leave now. I wanted to ask, sorry, please, was it Tiara that blocked him or Hadiza that blocked him, Tayo, in the episode? I was confused.
I don't know.
You don't?
I think it was Tiara.
You think it was Tiara? Okay. All right. Thank you very much. Bye. So Tiara blocked him. He then carried himself to Hadiza and finally opened up on why he doesn't think he fully loves Tiara. And it all boiled down to her being too childish for him. And also her drugs. Let's not forget about that. Also her drugs. And all I can say about this is, guy, maybe you should stop dating 18-year-olds. They all do drugs. Trust me. I know four drug addicts. I know 20 drug addicts. I'm one of them. I'm not one of them. I don't know where I'm getting this joke. Aminu's sister is someone I would love to see in season 4 because I know she will mess things up. That's what I want. Oh, also, Aminu is probably cheating. The perfect man in the world, guys, is probably cheating. Now, ladies, you will settle for less. My number is on the screen right now. Except I forgot to put it there, but it's on the screen. Call me, babes. And what an ending. Tonya getting pregnant and Louis had to leave his babe in the middle of doing something to rush there and stay smiling awkwardly as he was holding his child. He doesn't even know if that child is his own. But you know what they say. You don't need to know if the child is yours when you can run.
Try to get my head above sea levels. We are from this don't sea levels.
Thank you guys for watching. Guys, this was the final episode of TMC. It was nice reviewing it. Thank you very much to my Patreons. And thank you very much for showing me love in my last review. The song I used was the same song I used from the previous time. Please check out my friend. All his links are in the description. Oh, guys, I have a podcast that I do with my sister and just my family members in general. I'm not even saying anything. No, I'm not cutting this side. You guys should just listen. I don't care. Anyways, I have a podcast. If you guys could check it out, also linked in the description. It's called Zero Expectations. It'll be lovely. Follow me on all social media platforms so you'll be notified whenever I post, and you can also have the opportunity to tell me what I should post. If you want to support me with my Patreon, guys. Thank you guys for listening. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for doing everything. Question of the day, because question of the day. What is the color of your favorite shirt? Mine is pink. Bye, guys. I don't even know why it's pink. Don't ask me why it's pink.
Don't see levels. They stare at you to your face like they see devils. If you think you pro the girl, you never see rebels. Me and the clique stay fly, you never see Red Bulls. The wings we got made good girls get loose. Close ties with the plug like I own the fuse. Look nice, but I'm not, got her all confused. No lies when I speak, sworn to say the truth. The way I kick on my dog, you gon' love the